What's up, everybody? Thomas Bepko, Justin Acosta. Our weekly market update. Got some really good information. What's going on with the demand? What's going on with mortgage rates? What's going on from Stanford to Brantford? Let's go, Justin.
Well, there's a lot of news, especially in our towns here along the Connecticut shoreline. News coming in almost daily, as we like to cover here in our weekly videos. We're going to go over the numbers as always, but a lot of news and noise going in the refinancing space. And Thomas, tell us a little bit about how that's affecting the market and what it's doing to particular towns as well.
So there, according to the Mortgage Bankers Association, the refinance applications have picked up 67% from where they were last year, year over year, right? So that's a huge increase on top of the purchase market increasing, right? And there's a huge buyer activity. Last week, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac on cash out refinances are charging everybody 0.5%, meaning a half a point. Mortgage Bankers Association also said it would cost the average homeowner another $1,480 to refinance. Now, what did this do? Well, because of all the refinance transactions, making it more affordable to lower the interest rates, making housing affordable, it set the pace for the housing market, right? It set the pace for the buyer demand. Now, they're going back and forth. The FHFA is challenging Fannie and Freddie, saying, look, did you do this at the right time? Who knows? August is generally a slower month right now. Purchases are trending down a little bit, right? But again, who knows if kids are going back to school, right? August is everybody goes on vacation. They go back to school in September. They take their family vacation. They go to school, and we go.
Now. Right, and that's right in the meat of exactly where we are. People with even if you're going hybrid or full time, depending on what your school district is, this is the time of year where families take the last couple of weeks of summer, get away with the kids for a little while, kind of wind down, close out the summer, and then start back up here. Now, clearly the situation is a little bit different with COVID, back to school, not back to school. So we're going to see how that all plays out. Let's go over the numbers, TJ. Madison to Weston, usually Brantford to Westport. And now, yeah, Brantford to Stanford. And now we're going to check out go over the numbers, see how it's reflecting there, and we'll see as we go along that the purchases did come down a little bit, seems a little bit stagnant, but let's get in, right into it, right? Madison, 31 closing under contracts the previous week, 26 this week, so they're down a little bit. Brantford, 20 under contracts, 26 last week. East Haven, 18 last week, 21 this week. So, you know, fairly steady there. New Haven, 23 last week. This week, 27.
There's an increase.
West Haven, 30 down to 20. Milford went up, 41 last week, 50 this week.
Boom.
Stratford went from 61, had a really, really good beginning, end of July, beginning of August. Back down to earth a little bit here, 47 only for this week. Bridgeport saw a pretty good decrease as well for the under contract, 67 the previous week, 55 this week. Fairfield, small uptick, 78 previously, 82 this week. Norwalk went down just a few, 77 the previous, 75 this week. Stanford, and TJ, remind me, jog my memory, but I don't know if we've ever hit triple digits since we started doing our show. Stanford, beginning of July here, beginning of August, hits 104 for this past week. So I think that might be our first triple digits under contract. So we started doing this a few months ago. So 88 last week, 104 this week.
Stanford Metro. Hot. Yeah. Wow. Yeah, one stop from the city. One Metro North stop.
And that's got to be chewing into the inventory because the inventory has been pretty steady over the past month and a half. Haven't seen a real spike in any particular week. So I'd be curious to see where it's really left over at this point. Westport, 45 last week, 44 this week. Weston, 17 under contract, 14 under contract this week. Total closings across the whole state, 1301 compared to 1219. Stanford probably had a lot to do with that. And total new listings, just very bit, 1399, 1335 this week. So a very, very standard there. So we're seeing in most places, Sanford aside, either stagnant or maybe just down just a little bit. And, you know, now we're going to really get into the interesting part, school back to school, not back to school. What happens now? Are you, if your child is doing a hybrid situation, if they're fully online, are those families now feel a little bit more comfortable continuing their home shirts if they haven't found it yet? Moving, you know, but being able to work from home, things like that. Very interesting.
It's going to be interesting to see. We have Labor Day coming up, right? Then we go into September 21st, starts fall. So, again, I think we're going to go hot into the Indian summer. Not making a comment right now on election. I'm thinking there could be some type of movement. I don't know. I'd have to. I still got to think.
Is that every time there's an election year, no matter what it is, especially this year now, how it's contested and highly emotional, this election is going to be whatever it normally is, times it by 10. So, you know, there's still a lot of fireworks to go on, stock market, real estate market, political landscape, a lot of stuff coming up here, in the next 90 days or so.
And look, and if you guys want to hear about other towns, you have questions, if you're an agent out there, we know you're putting in 7 days a week, 20-hour days. I know most of us, it's pretty crazy. Hats off to all the essential workers, right? To the agents, to the bankers, everybody out there really making the housing market turn around. I think the housing market is paying, you know, getting really good for the economy right now, right? Jobs are picking up. You know, let's keep this pace up, and hats off to everybody.
Before we sign off, TJ and I were discussing right before we started the video is that even the stock prices of real estate companies are starting to shoot through the roof. Zillow is now over $80 a share. It was 60 before COVID, dropped down clearly when the stock market crashed when the virus hit. Now back way up over $80. EXP is going up dollar after dollar every day. They're almost at $30 a share. They started back just a few years ago, just a few dollars a share. They're out at almost 30. So we're seeing some of those real estate stocks really reflect of what's going on in the market. And again, we will see what the future holds.
Let's go. All right, you guys, everybody have a good, stay safe out there. Enjoy the summer, spend time with family, stay safe, wear a mask.
Peace.